Okay, so today is 6th of July morning. I'll be riding from Kathua to Gurgaon. Kathua is around 20 or 30 kilometers away from Pathankot. I tried to reach Pathankot yesterday, but then it was approximately 9 p.m., 8:30 or 9 p.m. and my main headlights were not working. So I could not reach Pathankot. I halted here. Also, yesterday's ride was fully exhaustive. More mentally tiring initially because of the Srinagar Valley and stuff. I was worried about a lot of things, but anyways, the Indian Army and the security over all that, and the security through all that valley made things far better. So let's go. Well, times have changed, dates have changed, so have the states, and so has the weather. It's fucking freaking hot now. For the past few days in the morning, even yesterday, while coming from Sonmark, I was only thinking about how cold it would be. Right now, it's just the opposite. And there's the border. Thank you for visiting Jammu and Kashmir. Please visit again. Sure, I will. Once all issues of Kashmir are resolved, sure, I will visit again Jammu and Kashmir. It all depends on the government, how quickly the issues can be resolved. Jammu and Kashmir is a wonderful state. The most beautiful state of India is Jammu and Kashmir, according to me. God, please, let Jammu and Kashmir be more beautiful every day. Just a roadside break beside this petrol pump. Also refilled my tank at Pathankot. After Pathankot somewhere. I've done just around 60 kilometers or something. Delhi abhi bahut dur hai. 460 something kilometers to Delhi. That's about it.
Okay. So I'm still around 30 or 40 kilometers away from Jalandhar. Back to network and connectivity. I can talk to Google whenever I want. That's a great thing. It's pretty hot, but when you're riding, the wind is not that unpleasant.
Took another break here. I just saw Subway MACD. Had a nice and cold kiwi juice, and I'll be leaving soon. It's not that hot today. I just hope it doesn't rain. If this kind of weather continues, it's great for me.
Okay, Delhi is around 130 kilometers from here. The weather has been pleasant.
I'm really happy about that.
I took a few breaks in between, which was really necessary. But apart from that, today's ride was pretty boring and also tiring, because if you consider for the past from Pangong Lake, ever since I went to Pangong Lake, from that day onwards, I have been riding every single day, and the ride for every single day has also been pretty tiring. Moreover, if you consider, my energy levels right now are not as high as when I left home. It is bound to take a toll on your health and energy levels. So anyways, 130 kilometers left for Delhi. I think I'll make it to Gurgaon within another 4 hours, because I will once again have to face the traffic jam in Delhi and Gurgaon. No, there was no option that I could have started sooner today. Most probably tomorrow I'm going to take a total day off or rest at Gurgaon, because the next 2 days I will again be riding from Gurgaon to Kolkata, which is around 1500 or 600 kilometers again. Oh my god, I've never ever seen such a small truck. What is it? A truck beneath it or something else? Baap re baap. Truck hai. Ab tractor. Reached yet another toll plaza. When you come to the plains, you get toll after toll after toll after toll. Finally, I reached Delhi, and it's around 5:10 right now. So traffic anytime should be at its peak. Pretty tired for the day today. I'll just go and sleep and take some rest tomorrow, because I need a long rest badly.
চো আগস্ট দেখা হচ্ছে টাটা। Okay, so this is the last leg of the journey and I have left from Gurgaon. My preferable destination for today would be Varanasi, which is around 800 something kilometers from here. Once again, I don't have any targets as such, but Varanasi would be a good choice because if I can do 800 plus kilometers today, tomorrow I would have to ride only about 600 kilometers from Varanasi to Kolkata. That would end my longest ride till now. I don't know how many kilometers in total. Maybe after when I reach, then I can calculate. And neither does the Pulsar 200NS odometer show you the complete trip meter, because whenever the trip meter reaches 1000, it resets to zero. So yes, you can track up till 1000 only. Bajaj never estimated that one could even ride this motorcycle for trips more than 1000 kilometers. I'm just kidding. Okay, so I am somewhere on the Yamuna Expressway and I am feeling damn sleepy. I just want to park my motorcycle somewhere and go off to sleep. Mathura is still 35 kilometers away from here and that sucks. Okay, so I just had some breakfast and a coffee just to charge me up for the ride ahead, because I will probably not be stopping for lunch anymore.
Chalo bhai.
It was great to meet you. So I just met Amber, another rider on the way on the Yamuna Expressway. So it was nice to meet other people on the way, right? Very bad road accident.
Okay, I have crossed Itawa, done with the Yamuna Expressway, currently heading towards Kanpur, which is around 152 kilometers from here. Yes, I'm not feeling sleepy anymore. The weather is perfectly fine right now. It did drizzle a little bit in between, but apart from that, it has been awesome.
Okay, so finally I have reached Varanasi. Sorry, I could not vlog this whole time because it was raining very heavily. Right now I am completely wet. I mean everything. I guess probably my luggage is also wet. There were some places where it was not raining, but most of the route it was raining pretty heavily, and that was a big problem for me. So now that I've reached Varanasi, I need to find a proper hotel for me. I'll probably Google it out and just look for a hotel. So Varanasi does not have any place to stay just near the highway. I just asked a local guy. I don't know, might be there, maybe one or two, but then there are not much that I see. So the city is around 10 to 15 kilometers away from the highway. So he said that, he and a couple of other fellows also said that I have to go ahead into the city to get a hotel. I mean, it's a very dark place. There are no lights and nothing. It does not even feel that I'm coming close to a city like Varanasi. Anyways, I might be still far off. I'm still looking for a hotel and stuck at a railway crossing. There's the Rajdhani going away. If I did not ride, there was my Rajdhani tickets booked. Tomorrow evening I had my backup tickets booked. But then since I'm traveling alone, loading the motorcycle on a parcel van, keeping track of the saddlebags, duffel bag, my tank bag and so much luggage, everything, doing that alone is a big thing. I mean, it's nearly impossible. So that's why I decided to ride. Okay, I just checked into the Park Inn at Varanasi. All my clothes and stuff are wet. I'm currently just drying them. I mean, monsoon has seriously shown its fury today. Tomorrow is the last day of my ride in this trip.
So I've just started from Varanasi. Yeah, I started pretty late today because today is the last day of the ride. It's 8:45 a.m. now. I'm hoping I'll reach Kolkata by 10 or 11 p.m. maximum. Let's see, depends on the rains, the road conditions and everything. So that's about it. It's already raining. It was already drizzling in Varanasi. But then I had a good breakfast. I stayed at the Hotel Park Inn.
Whoa man, that was approximately 19 days of riding across 6700 kilometers. I mean, the riding was the fun part as well, and the editing was also fun part. But then, you know, for these 19 days, there was a hell lot of footage, around 450 GB of footage that I recorded in Ladakh. Well, obviously, the last
two or three days I could not record that much because I was very tired. In fact, when I was riding for the past few days continuously, after that I got tired. My energy levels were not that high so as to do a proper vlog. So yes, I tried to capture footage and give updates on the way, but then due to the rains, specifically after I left from Gurgaon, due to the heavy rains, as you have already seen, due to the heavy rains and all, I could not bring out my camera because it's not waterproof. So I had to keep it in, and it was raining cats and dogs, which is why I could not record the footage for the last 2 days. But I guess it's okay because I came using the same route. When I was coming to Ladakh, I came using the same route, so that you can go ahead and watch that one if you want to watch the route from Kolkata to Delhi or Gurgaon. That's it. After I have started YouTubing, this Ladakh series was the third major trip that I did after I started YouTubing. So apart from this Ladakh, before that I had done a Vizag ride and also gone to India's highest accessible lake. There is Gurudongmar. So those were two of my major rides which are there in YouTube. If you want to watch the Sikkim or the Gurudongmar ride one, ride series, do use headphones because at the time my mic was not that good. So stay tuned. There are really some interesting footage and interesting videos that are going to come up. Yes, I have a few rides planned, and as I have those plans perfectly set, I will reveal the update them to you over here. If there is anything, any questions or anything that you want to ask, just shoot them in the comment section below and I'll be obviously replying them. So guys, if you really love the Ladakh series, do not forget to subscribe and share it with your friends. I did it only because whenever you used to post day one, I got such nice encouragement and feedback from you. So that's why I kept on making day 2, day 3, day 4 and completed the whole Ladakh series. As always, keep supporting guys, and do share the videos with your friends and family. Apart from YouTube, I'm also on Facebook and Instagram. You can also like my Facebook page, which is at facebook.com/onelivinglife.in. And you can also follow me on Instagram. My Instagram ID is one_living_life. I also got a lot of feedback from you, like you guys want to know about the budget for Ladakh and whatever cost I incurred during whatever expenses I had done during my trip to Ladakh and all. So yes, I will make another video, short little video on that, and then probably release it within a couple of days. Do not forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.